We look for various solutions to make our website look dynamic. And one of these solutions is to add a dynamic air to the links. When hovered over, links that are underlined in a moving way look very nice. It is also extremely simple to make. We can see such effects on websites, especially in the navigation section of the sites. This is actually a simple CSS technique. Let's get started. We will make all these arrangements through the Visual Studio Code program. After opening the program, let's first create our index.html page. I save the file as index.html. It is on the left side. Let's start writing our basic codes immediately. We are writing our basic HTML codes. And then we will write a text between the body tags. It can be a text like this. Of course, we don't necessarily need to give the underlined animation to links. We can give it to normal text or anything else. The important thing is how we get here through the CSS code and the codes of the effect we are going to give. After writing this text here, I will need to import the CSS file here since we will analyze this animation through CSS. That's why I'm calling style.css between the head tags. I'm saving this. We don't have style.css. For this, I create a new page and save its name as style.css. And style.css is created. Now we move to the style.css file to define the visual arrangements and the underline. The first codes we wrote are the codes written on the body tag. I'm adding these codes here for a completely visual layout. When I save this, you will see that it takes this shape on the right side. When we look at the index.html file, we define the pclass as text. This information is important for us. And here we define the text class of the p tag. So it will remember this part in index.html and we add before property to it. Since it is before, I first write the content part as empty. We define absolute in the position section. With this absolute, we write zero values to left and bottom. Thus, our line will start from the left side and bottom. We make the width value 0. We specify the line thickness with the height value and we specify the color of the line with the background color expression. Now, here is what we need to pay attention to. The width value is 0. The line doesn't have any width to start with. We didn't recognize it in this way. We need to specify what the width value will be when we hover over it. I'm writing the pclass line here again. After the colon, I write hover because it will apply this system when we hover over the text and I write before again. How what did we say here? The width value was 0. The width value will be 100% when we hover over the text. Therefore, I'm setting this to be 100%. Let's save this. Now, when we check, you will see this line at the bottom of the page. This is not what we wanted. We want it to be completely under the text. So we will need to define a definition for the pclass. I'm adding the display inline block line. I'm also adding the padding button and position lines. Let's check how it is again. As you can see, when we hovered over the text, the button became a line. So where is the animation of this? Now it's time to animate this. In CSS, animations are given with transition. Therefore, we will add an animation to the part we wrote before. So we will add a transition line. What will the transition affect? It will affect the width. We write how long we want it to take to complete. We set it to be a quarter of a second. You can change it as you like. And to add softness to this movement, we write the easy out expression. Now I'm saving it and look at it again. And as you can see, we got what we wanted. When we mouse over the text, the underline expands as much as the text. As soon as we move the mouse over the text, it closes again from right to left. It is also possible to do it the other way around. For example, if you wanted the line to go from right to left, we can make the left value here right. When I save it this way and look at it, the line will go from right to left. If you want the line to be above the text, we need to make the bottom part top. As you can see, in this case, it will be above the text. Now let's take it back and move it to the position it should be. You can give this not only the paragraphs, but also to a text, for example. It is up to you. You can use this in any way. If you refer to the a tag in the index.html file instead of the paragraph here, this time when you hover over the link, there will be a line. As you can see, we can add a dynamic atmosphere to our articles and links with a few lines of code that we can call simple. That's it for this web development and CSS tutorial. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.